Magic Lantern for the R series. You look into rumours that the R5 series could soon see restrictions lifted with Magic Lantern. Hi, I'm Tom and you're watching Rumour Has It. Please consider subscribing for camera news, rumour and informed opinion. In this video we'll talk about what Magic Lantern is and how I've used it in the past. We'll move on to what prevents ML being used in more recent cameras. Before we talk about the latest news that there might be a breakthrough in bringing these features to the R series. Perhaps we'll be able to determine if the timers are indeed the root cause of overheating. I've put timestamps into the description below, but why not keep watching? It's only 5 minutes. I first used Magic Lantern on my 650D and later on my 5D Mark III. The most useful features I found were additional overlays like golden ratio or Fibonacci sequence, passport templates, or make your own template and add it to the camera. All of those features were available. Then there was Magic Zoom. This allows you to zoom while filming in video. That's still not available in recent cameras. Audio peaking bars in full colour was a useful addition. And then intervalometer, although some Canon models now allow this. But additions like motion detect to trigger the camera and frames per second override to create a video at any frame rate for time lapse were all options still worth having. Also, the battery percentage indicator was a useful addition, as was the automatic restart for filming, set to automatically recommence after 29 minutes 59 seconds. It's still a required feature on even the latest cameras. Focus bracketing was another feature that only recently been added to some models. Raw video in some modes is again only available on some newer models. As you've heard, Magic Lantern was and is very useful for unlocking Canon features that Canon don't allow. So where are we now? Well, until recently Magic Lantern's been lagging behind a bit. The latest Digic processors from the Digic 7 onwards have been tougher to crack and development has been very slow. So what does the future hold? Well, the popularity of cameras like the M50 and the Eos R and RP seem to have breathed new life into the community. Just to be clear, not all Canon DSLR or mirrorless cameras can use Magic Lantern. The M3, M5, M6, M10 and M100 are all based on PowerShot. Only the Eos M, M2 and M50 are based on Eos firmware. And of course the R series. So it's exciting news that Magic Lantern contributors are working on the Eos R, and the Eos R and R6 have recently been found to have a hidden UART port. What does that mean? Well, the UART port can be used to set the boot flag. In a way, it's a way around firmware encryption, and also allows access to the ROM dump. Sorry if all this electronic language is foreign to you, but basically it increases the chances of being able to download the ROM file. That's the read-only memory. This holds the data on temperature and timer limits, as well as many other camera settings, and could open up the ability to play with them. This is great news and means we could possibly see Magic Lantern working on the R series cameras in the near to mid-term. If this happens, we can look forward to seeing if Canon are indeed limiting the camera for no good reason. Thanks for watching Rumour Has It. I hope you found this useful. Please subscribe for more camera news, rumour and informed opinion.